Hello there, amazing and wonderful geeky people of YouTube. So this is Sunday and this is my big update day. Every Sunday I go over all my VMs, update them, even though I do it during the week, but sometimes I don't play much in all VMs, so I just go through all VMs. And I'm in Fedora, and it makes me think a little bit, if that's even possible. But I was thinking that I'm starting to dig Fedora more and more while I'm using it in the virtual machine. I think I had Fedora 31 installed at one point under my on my physical hardware. And I'm just clicking some stuff so you guys can see me do something on the screen while I'm talking, because this will mostly just be me talking. I kinda are digging it more and more. I have always seen myself as in the Ubuntu Debian camp or the Arch camp, you know, Manjaro, Arch Linux, or Arch Linux derivative, like what you call it, Salient OS and all those, and Endeavor OS. Because I like rolling releases, and if I want a really, really stable, static release, I tend to go with Ubuntu or Ubuntu-driven distributions. The thing with Fedora is it sits kind of like in the middle. One thing I don't fancy that much with rolling releases, or especially Arch, is that that sometimes you get 2 or 3 update cycles in a day. I don't really like that. Fedora seems to be they call them a semi-rolling release. I call it an aggressively updating. They update a lot, but they don't seem to be so chaotic with their updates as as Manjaro and Arch seems to be doing. And they have a great community. And there's a good amount of help to be found. But when I look at YouTubers and stuff like that, Fedora is one of those distributions that are not talked much about, which I find a little bit crazy, to be honest. Which I find a little bit curious, because it's not a bad distribution. If you go on to Phionix, and I know a lot of people don't like Phionix, it's the best, or the best guys we have at the moment that do Linux benchmarks. It's not the fastest, okay? But it's not the slowest either. It sits kind of like in the middle. As I have talked about in many of my videos, you don't really notice a lot of performance issues between distributions unless you have a specific use case, like you're rendering videos 18 hours a day, or you are doing database optimization, database searches, or compression, you know, file compression and stuff like that. If you're just a stock standard user, or even a gamer, or even a Linux YouTuber that do, you know, one video a day or 2 videos a day, you don't really notice that much of a difference. We will say we were talking 1 to 5 frames between the distributions, and we are talking a couple of seconds between rendering options in distributions and stuff like that. So you will not really notice that big of a difference. That's just what I have noticed. And I was wondering this, like, if there is any of you guys out there that are watching my videos that are using Fedora or are having it as a, I would not say a backup, but are using it as a secondary distribution that they log into once in a while, have it in a virtual machine as I have and stuff like that. Or are you using Fedora? So I kind of want to know, why are you using Fedora and why are you not using Fedora? I know some people have a problem with that Fedora is an RPM-based distribution. My experience, I have never had RPM problems. I had in the late 90s and early 2000s, the last 10 plus years, no problem whatsoever with the RPM hill and what you will call it that a lot of people are talking about. It's a non-issue anymore, if you ask me, of course. And you can get what you want with Fedora. They have, you know, the RPM Fusion repositories. I think it's like, is it RPM Fusion? Is that what it's called? Yeah, RPM Fusion. And there are actually Fedora developers contributing to RPM Fusion. And if you think of this like the AUR, just done better than the AUR. In my opinion, the AUR is security. If you look at it from a security and stability aspect, it's a nightmare. It's like way bad. And this is community repos done right. The same with the Pac-Man repo from OpenSUSE or what the fuck. I can't remember the other ones, but you get my idea here. The AUR, it's not that. I'm sorry. I love Arch. It's just one big aspect of Arch that I don't agree with, and I don't find that alluring about Arch. Also because you have to use a second package manager to handle the AUR, where here you're using DNF. You get what I'm saying? In OpenSUSE you're using zip, but in other distributions you're using the same package manager. Like in Ubuntu, you can add app sources, you can add PPAs, you're still just using apt or apt-get. That's basically it. That's also a thing I don't like that much about. So Fedora's bringing a lot of things to the table. So I'm wondering, why are more people not using it? Why are more people not talking about it? Why am I not using it? Because right now I have migrated over to Manjaro because of some Ubuntu issues that I don't agree with and stuff like that. So I'm in a Manjaro runner right now, been it for like a month now or something like that. And I've been using Manjaro mainly on my virtual machines when I'm doing dev work and research and stuff like that. I've been in Manjaro, but every time I go on to Fedora, I do the updates, sometimes I reboot, but I do the updates and it just hecks along, you know. It's like a diesel engine. In my case, it's stable, it don't break, it just keep going along. It's kind of like the Debian. If you took a rolling release, like a proper rolling release, this is kind of like the RPM Debian version, if you can say it like that, or the RPM version of Debian testing. I sometimes have some problems with packages in Debian testing. Some packages are not there, but they are in the stable repo and stuff like that. Where here, everything is here, and I can set up flat packages, I can set up snap packages. Really, really easy. If you set up snap packages in Arch, it's a little bit of an issue. And I know some of you guys hate snaps. I am one of those people that are like, app images, flat packages, or snaps, they are all good. They all have their faults. I just find that snaps give me better quality packages, more updated packages, and more variety. So that's why I like to use them. But again, we have to do stuff like this to enable snaps. You hear? To enable snaps, we actually have to go through the AUR, which I don't like. Or we have to do this kind of things down here. Where under Fedora, it's basically a two command. If you want classic snap support, it's a two command deal. You have to do this up here, and you have to do this one up here. So why am I not using it? Is it previous conception and indoctrination about how RPM was back in the day and how people were looking at Fedora and Red Hat back in the day, because they have not always been looked upon in the most positive light. You know, their package manager was slow as balls and this didn't work and this break and all that. And I have to say, again, over the last like 5-10 years, it's not as the package manager is not Arch speed. Arch has one of the fastest package managers out there, don't get me wrong, but it's not the slowest either. I would say it's on par with apt-get or apt on Debian. And you don't have to go in with Pacman under Arch, you know. If you don't have hooks or manually go in and delete caches and stuff like that, you can easily fill up your hard drive with a lot of gigabytes of space that you don't know is being filled up with old packages in case you want to roll back. And a lot of people, I had this a couple of times where people asked me, oh, where's, I use Arch, where's all my disk space gone? And I'm like, how long have you ran it? 6 months and stuff like that. Yeah, try and delete your cache folder. And then they delete it with pack cache or what it's called. And sometimes they get like gigabytes and gigabytes free space, which again, I think it's an oversight. There should be an auto clean system or something like that. Video for another time. So Fedora brings a lot of things to the table. So why, again, I'm kind of like, I want you guys to convince me to use it. Because when I do videos on Arch or something like that, they tend to get good feedback, you know, good views, good interaction and stuff like that. Where if I do it on Ubuntu or Ubuntu derivative distributions, it's not that the case. If I do it on Arch Manjaro, it's kind of like the same as Fedora. People like it, they like to see it and stuff like that. So I'm just curious, why are we not embracing this distribution so much? Another thing I like about Arch, or not Arch, Fedora, is their packages. They don't do much, if anything, you know, to the packages other than testing them and making sure that there are no security in them and all that, where Ubuntu, they put, you know, little Ubuntu spices into packages sometimes. They do that also with Snap packages to some extent, if it's maintained by Canonical or Ubuntu folks. So it's not like package default, so meaning that it's not 100% how the developer intended it. I think it is that with Arch also, but also with Fedora, I kind of see the same, what you call it, paradigm, that they don't mess around with the packages so much, other than fixing securities and stability issues and stuff like that. Like, if I install Inkscape here, it's the same Inkscape I get under Arch, you know, it looks the same. They have not, like, messed around with it or moved some libraries or stuff like that. But anyway, that's just what I will talk to you guys about without rambling too much. I just find this really, really interesting. So the takeaway here is, are you using Arch? If you are, why? If you're not, why not? And if you're like in the middle, why are you in the middle? What good things do you see about Arch? I'm talking about Fedora. I probably have said Arch before, but I meant Fedora. What good things do you see Fedora is doing? What bad things or negative things or things that you don't like do you see with Fedora? You know, give me some feedback, because I kind of like what you guys are saying sometimes about these distributions here. And if it's some opinion that, oh, I don't like it because in 2005 or 2001 someone took a poop on the corporate copy machine and wrote Fedora in it, so I don't want to use Fedora anymore, well, I can't use that for anything. See you all later. Bye-bye.